The storm door, most of the project's going to be easy, but I'm going to tell you this. This is the tricky part at first. This is what you call a template, and it pops on and off. And I got it into place, so I'm not going to pop it off. But look how it fits flush right there. And then right there, you can see that little indentation lines up with another hole. So if you bought one of these certain Larson doors, you're going to have to drill your handle holes. And I'm going to go slow and methodical when I do that. And notice there is a exterior side. Then you have something that says drill. What we're going to do today is focus on the handle part. It comes with no holes there. And so you have to put this template. See how it fits flush? It fits right on there. So what I'm going to do from here is note that it says exterior, and I'm outside, so it says exterior, and then you get drill, and then drill. The other ones are upside down. Don't drill there, just drill where it tells you to drill. And you're gonna use a 30 seconds to get it started. If you watch my other videos, you know that I like the Bosch drill. It's 18 volt, whatever, just get an 18 volt drill. Get a lithium. You will be wasting your time if you have another junky tool. So I got my 3/32 bit in there, and the good folks at Larson give you this spade. So you're going to pre-drill a tiny bit with that, and then you're going to pop this in there and make your hole bigger. So that's that. Let's see if we can show you something on that. I'm making sure everything's still lined up there. Hopefully a lot of you are appreciating this, because, you know, it takes a lot to stop working and videotape something. So here's the template, right? And my spade got that and got that. Let's rotate around, and I did this. Holes look pretty clean. The template stayed in place. That was my biggest concern. And so you do have to have a good quality drill. Don't be afraid. That steel's not that thick, but the piece that you drill out is probably going to fall down there somewhere. Who cares? But that's how it's going to look. The two holes I drilled seemed to turn out pretty good. The template is good. The hardware piece that says up right there, so you can't screw that up, and it's going to slide into there. So they got some pretty good instructions on that, but just give you an idea how that's going to go. It's like that right there. And the screw right here that goes there, you take that out until further notice. So go ahead and take that out and put it somewhere safe. Don't put it in your blue jean shorts pocket. Let me, this is going to be very interesting. Whenever you look at 8C, this is the lock mechanism. This is called the faceplate. They say to unloosen this screw right there so that you can rotate that piece right there. So it's kind of weird how you do this, and the reason you have to do it like this is because the door is left and right, so it just kind of pushes in. Sorry for bad camera work. And then it's going to pop right into the slot. So there you can see how it's going to go. It's all because I unloosened that top screw that this piece in here rotates. Super important. Don't get your stuff installed and realize you didn't rotate that. This is super important, and if you had hung it on the other side, you wouldn't have to mess with it, but because I have a left hand or a left hinge, I have to get this piece in there. See how it did that? And now I got to tighten this screw up right there. Earlier I told you to drill only two holes. I was wrong. You got to drill right there and right there as well. And you do that on this side as well back here. Why? Because this thing's going to mount up to it. So it's going to look something like that. So you can see I got those two holes, but I need holes for this other one as well. So it's all still the same size. Okay, so if your door hangs on the left like mine does, you're going to need four holes. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Moral of the story is if you have a butler and he says, hey, let me pick up some of your trash and throw it in the garbage for you, whatever it is, tell him to get lost for a little bit and let you do your job. You might have to come back and get some of your tools or whatever. So anyway, I'm getting ready to put the piece in. So far, it's been a good experience. It's been a good experience with the Larson, but the problem is these screws that they gave for this handle set will not go into here at all. They simply keep turning. So that means I got to call Larson tomorrow and get replacement screws or go back to the hardware store. Thumbs down on that part of the install.